गेट रेडी स्टार्ट। मैडम आई शुड लाइक टू रेफर टू सम ऑफ द वोट्स ऑन दिस बिल, पर्टिकुलरली वोट नंबर 50 रिगार्डिंग द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ होम अफेयर्स। अ गुड डील हैज़ बीन सेड अबाउट द नीड फॉर द रिलैक्सेशन ऑफ द प्रेजेंट स्टेट ऑफ इमरजेंसी। आई वुड नॉट बी वन ऑफ दोज who would like to weaken the defense effort of the government, and I think that the time has come in view of our experience of the proclamation of the emergency for us to think in terms of amending the constitution, increasing the powers of the union government in respect of the control of the economic life of this country. This should be a part of our regular constitutional framework. What I should like to see is the incorporation of a large number of provisions of the Defense of India Act in the constitutional powers which the Union Government enjoys at present, particularly those powers relating to the economic life of the community. I'm not very happy at the large number of persons who have been detained in jail, and in view of the general relaxation of conditions on the border, I think that the time has come for government to release all persons unconditionally. At present, by elections are being held in various states, and it means that the election commission as well as the government of India have come to accept the position that the conditions are so far improved that the ordinary democratic processes can function. If that is the case, there is no need whatever for the detention of persons in jail on account of the emergency. What I should like to recommend to the government is that, barring the provisions that they have in respect of the control of the economic life of the community, they should allow normal conditions to return. Now I should like to refer to vote number 9 on the defense services. I believe it is generally known to this house and the country that recruitment to the army has not been satisfactory, and that a large number of young persons have not come forward to offer themselves for recruitment. There have been pockets of grievances in many states that persons who could not answer in English at the interview have been rejected, and a deputation waited on the Prime Minister to urge upon him the need for review of cases of rejection. In view of the fact that Hindi has become the official language of this country since 1965, I think that the time has come for the army authorities to conduct the oral examination at least in the regional languages of the country, the regional languages recognized by the constitution, and in English and in Hindi, so that we try to see how far the candidates who offer themselves for oral examination come up to the requirements of the army test. आई डू होप दैट एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ द एफर्ट्स दैट गवर्नमेंट विल मेक इन दिस कनेक्शन अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ पर्सन्स विल कम फॉरवर्ड टू ऑफर themselves फॉर रिक्रूटमेंट टू द आर्मी. मैडम आई शुड लाइक ऑल्सो टू रेफर इन दिस कनेक्शन टू द फीलिंग दैट पर्सन्स हु ऑफर themselves फॉर रिक्रूटमेंट फ्रॉम अमंग द गवर्नमेंट सर्वेंट्स आर अनसर्टेन ऑफ दे आर फ्यूचर प्रोस्पेक्ट्स. I believe that under the present laws that exist, if a member of the civil service of the government offers himself for recruitment and is discharged from the army, he gets all the benefits in respect of his pension, but he has got to return his gratuity and other emoluments which he receives from the army and his seniority in the civil service when he reverts to the civil service after discharge is not protected. On that ground, a large number of persons who are civilian employees of the government are not prepared to offer themselves for recruitment to the army. Persons who are in the civilian employment of the government, persons who have the necessary administrative experience can be usefully utilized for the running of the supply corps and the administrative service of the defense ministry. I think that government should waive the present restrictions in respect of civilian employees offering themselves for recruitment to the army and give the civilian personnel the right to seniority on the basis of their army service when they revert to their civilian employment after their discharge from the army. I hope that the defense minister will look into this matter. I would also like to refer to the general feeling of disquiet that is there in this country about defense expenditure. The report of the defense ministry does not give adequate information about what is going on in the defense ministry. My good friend, who was a member of the old Central Legislative Assembly, will bear me out when I say that under the British government, we got more information about the army.